Shaun of the Shed, an AMI original podcast.
Hello and welcome back to Shaun of the Shed. I am Shaun Preece and this is my shed. Today I want to talk about Windows Hello. Yes, it's a great feature in Windows 10 and 11, which adds biometric security to your computer. Sounds all high-tech and posh, right? Biometric. But what it basically means is that you can use a fingerprint or facial recognition or even iris recognition in order to sign into your computer and basically handle all your security instead of relying on a password or a PIN number. So, why would you want to do this? Well, as I mentioned, biometric security is far more secure than using a password or PIN code. Now, there's lots of high-tech reasons for this that I'm not going to get into because I don't know them. But basically, if you listen to the experts out there, they will tell you that biometric security is far more secure. There's reasons about man-in-the-middle attacks when it comes to passwords being stored on servers, you know, hacking, server breaches, all that sort of thing. But for me, the main thing is that it's just more convenient. I don't have to type anything. I don't have to remember anything. As long as I've got my finger or my face on me, I'm good to sign into my computer. It's just easier. Now, I'm sure you're aware that most modern devices already come with fingerprint scanners or Face ID cameras built into them. There is a reason for that, as I said, convenience. You don't have to type things on tiny keyboards when it comes to your smartphone. But again, it is down mainly to security. But what if you've got a computer that doesn't have a fingerprint scanner or facial recognition built in already? Well, the answer is, thankfully, it's easy to add it. I have in my hand here something called the Arcanite Fingerprint Reader. All it is a USB dongle. It's a tiny, tiny little thing I'm holding between my fingers here. And when you plug it into any USB port on any computer, it will be recognized by Windows, and Windows will install the drivers without you having to do anything. And then it's just a case of setting up your fingerprint. So that's what I'm going to do today. I have here a fairly modern laptop, a Lenovo laptop, but it doesn't have any fingerprint reader built in. So I'm going to add the Arcanite. And of course, it's all accessible. We're going to do it without eyes, just using a screen reader. If you do a search for USB fingerprint scanner in any online store, you'll come up with quite a few different options. So why did I go for the Arcanite fingerprint reader? Well, a couple of reasons, but the main one, it was cheap. You know me, let's say it was affordable. That sounds better. If you search in the Canadian Amazon store, you'll find this for around $37. In the UK Amazon store, it's around £26-27. So very affordable. And again, it's a very tiny little dongle. It plugs into any USB-A slot on your computer. Now, when you do plug it in, it sticks out the side or wherever, sticks out the port about 1 centimeter. So it doesn't protrude, I'll use that word, too far. It's not likely that you're going to knock it by accident and do any damage. So it's actually quite nice and flush. It's a nice little device. Plus, if you don't want it sticking out of your computer, or maybe your computer's just too far away to make it convenient as a fingerprint scanner, you could, of course, attach or use a USB extension cable and stick the scanner maybe under your desk. Now, maybe it would work with USB ports on your monitor, and you also get sometimes USB ports built into your computer. I don't see any reason why you couldn't use either of them as well, although I haven't tried it. So test it out and see, and let me know. So there you go. This is the Arcanite USB scanner. So all I'm going to do is plug it into my laptop here. As I said, I have a Lenovo laptop which doesn't have a built-in fingerprint scanner. So let's plug this in. Let me just feel around for the side for the port. There it is, and boop. There you go. Now, as I said, Windows and this device work very well together. It's a plug-and-play device, so it will automatically download all the drivers that you need. You don't have to do a thing. This is going to be so easy, I hope. Famous last words. So give it a minute or two. You may get some information popping up telling you that your new device is ready to use, or it may say nothing. We will wait and see, but just wait a few minutes. And then when you're ready, let's set up your fingerprint. To do this, we're going to hit the Windows key on your keyboard to bring up the start menu. So once you bring up your start menu, we're just going to type fingerprint.
Set up fingerprint sign-in, system settings, press right to switch preview one of one.
There it is, that's what we want. Now, if that option doesn't come up as the top of the list, then you will find it in there somewhere. So just move up and down through the list till you find it, and then hit enter to open Windows settings.
Settings, settings window, search box, find a setting, edit blank.
Okay, so I'm going to tab through. Where focus jumps you on this settings screen is a little bit random, I find. So let's just tab through until we find what I'm looking for.
Account 7 of 12 level 1. Accounts button 1 of 2. Ways to sign in grouping. List. Facial recognition. Windows Hello. 1 of 4.
Okay, so here we are. Ways to sign in to Windows. It's a list, so I'm just going to arrow down. The first item there was facial recognition. We may get into that another time. For now, let's just arrow down.
Fingerprint recognition, Windows Hello, 2 of 4.
Beautiful, that's what we want. And now I'm going to hit tab. By the way, I'm using NVDA as my screen reader. Yours may be slightly different how you navigate around. Let's hit tab.
Fingerprint recognition, Windows Hello. Grouping sign in with your fingerprint scanner, recommended. Show all settings button collapsed.
There we go. Now, as you heard, it said the more options in this setting is collapse. So you want to hit space or enter on here to expand.
Space. Expanded.
And now let's tab through.
Set up another finger grouping. Add a finger button.
Now, I've been using this fingerprint scanner for about 6 months already, and I've already obviously set it up with my fingerprint. When you do this for the first time, you will see a button here saying setup. But once you hit space or enter on that, as I'm about to do on this add another fingerprint button, the process will be exactly the same as I'm going to go through now.
Set up another finger grouping. Add a finger button.
So let's hit enter on add a finger.
Windows Hello setup window. Get started button. Your device just got more personal. Say goodbye to entering complex passwords and start using your fingerprint to unlock your device, verify your identity and buy things in the store.
Ooh. Okay, tab.
Cancel button.
And again.
Learn more link.
And again.
Get started button. Your device just got.
Okay, don't hear that again. Get started. Let's hit enter on that.
Windows security dialog. Windows security making sure it's you. I forgot my pin. Pin edit protected blank.
Okay, so before we can go back and make any changes to any security settings on Windows computers, we obviously need to re-enter our PIN code or password. So let me just do that.
Start. Windows Hello setup window. Cancel button.
Okay, so in this next window, it starts at the very bottom. Focus is down there. So let's go to the top of the window and read what it says.
Swipe your finger on the fingerprint sensor. Continue swiping until Windows Hello setup is complete. Cancel button. No next.
Okay, pretty straightforward, right? So all I'm going to do is swipe my finger over the fingerprint scanner. Now, I'm just
swiping your finger.
Hello. From up to bottom, up to down, and left to right.
Swipe again.
All over.
Great, keep swiping.
USB dongle here.
Swipe your finger. Swipe again. Great, keep swiping.
Great.
Swipe your finger. Swipe again.
It does take a little while, but it's very easy.
Great, keep swiping. Swipe your finger.
So swiping backwards and forwards, up and down.
Swipe again. Great, keep swiping.
Just tapping the fingerprint scanner now.
Swipe your finger.
And
swipe
moving.
Again. Great, keep swiping.
And as you can hear, it's very verbose, so you're never unsure of what's happening.
Swipe your finger.
Even though it can seem like it's taking a while.
All set.
All set.
Use your fingerprint the next time you want to unlock your device.
We're done. That was pretty painless, wasn't it? And as I said, your screen reader will keep you updated into where you are in the process. Keep going, or you're not doing it correct. It will also tell you that as well. I've had that a couple of times. But that's basically it. It's incredibly easy and very accessible. So now Let's see how this works. I'm going to lock my computer and we'll try and sign in using the fingerprint. And by the way, let me say this. This biometric security is going to become more and more popular in the coming months and years because you'll be able to use your fingerprint or facial recognition, Windows Hello basically, in order to sign into websites and services. Now that has been an ability that's been out there for years, but recently I've noticed, thanks to something called passkeys and passphrases, that it's being far more widely implemented. So things like Dropbox, maybe Outlook account, for example, you can use Windows Hello biometric security to log in. It's just something that is going to be more and more widely used in the future. So it's kind of the reason I'm talking about it now as well, because I've seen a lot more of it popping up. Anyway, so we've set up our fingerprint. So what I'm going to do now, I'm not going to restart the computer. That's far too complicated. All I'm going to do is lock the computer and then sign back in. So to lock the computer, I'm going to hit the Windows key and the letter L. So let's do that now.
Secure Windows default lock screen window. Lock screen. Secure desktop.
Okay.
Window sign in dialog. Shaun Preece to sign in. Scan your finger on the fingerprint reader.
Scan your finger. So I'm going to do exactly that.
Desktop list.
Wow, and we're in! So much faster than typing a password or even a PIN code. The response time, it says in the blurb for the Arcanite, is 0.05 milliseconds. And I've got to say, it feels that quick. The time I touch the dongle, it's virtually instantaneous that I'm logged in. I love it. As I said, I have been using this a while and my experience is that it's very reliable. I haven't had many times where it's rejected my fingerprint, other than when it's been full of gravy or crumbs or grease. But mostly, it's worked amazingly well. As I said, I think this is something that you will find is offered much more in the future for doing things like managing your passwords or just logging into websites. It's just so convenient and accessible, as I hope I've demonstrated today. So that's it for this episode of Shaun of the Shed. Short and sweet, I hope you agree. If you liked this video, please click on the like button. If you want to see more, then click on subscribe and hit that bell. I don't know what that means. Hit the bell thing and you will get notifications when I upload a new one. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. I will see you next time. Bye.